if you were a really good therapist, like if you are really honest and willing to really challenge people's perceptions, you would say to these people, look, this family thing is a complete mythology. These people had sex, they gave birth to you, and they housed you when you were growing up. That's it. There's nothing that you owe them. If you don't find pleasure in them, there's nothing that you have to give them at all, whatsoever, ever. In fact, if you do give them things unjustly, you will make yourself miserable, you will make your husband or your wife miserable, and by God, you are going to make your children miserable. And that is something that is just so unspoken in society, and it's so unspoken in the general media. Nobody ever hears this, because it's true, right? So anything that's said in the general media is false. Now,
being honest about your negative experiences based upon their behavior is really important, and it teaches them that their decisions have impacts on other people. And don't shield them from the reality that actions have emotional consequences for other people. And you can point out things that you've done for them. You know, like, I mean, you could say, look, I mean, if I went to, like, when we went to Florida, I wouldn't be going to Disney World if I didn't have kids. Now, I didn't hate Disney World, and it was fun to be there, but I wouldn't have done that if I didn't have kids, because then I'd just be some creepy guy in Disney World for no discernible reason. And, but pointing out that you do things for them that is more for their benefit than yours is important. Like, once you've made the, quote, sacrifices for your children, when they get older, you can legitimately demand those sacrifices back. And they can't really give you a logical reason as to why that shouldn't be reversible, right? Whatever you do is universalizable when they get old enough, right?